Good afternoon. Welcome to Weekend Review with Jonathan. Today is 28th of August 2011. Now, before I start off my weekend review for this week, let me share with you a disclaimer. Whatever I shared is just my personal opinion. If you'd like to trade based on what I've shared, please consult your authorized broker because I'm not your licensed broker or remisier. Okay, it's been a fruitful week. A lot of things has happened over the past week. So let's recap what happened last week. Of course, the major news everyone still remembers right now is what Ben Bernanke did. Okay, what Ben Bernanke did on Friday, 10 p.m. Now, let me introduce to you Mr. Ben Bernanke. Hi. It's been a fantastic holiday in Jackson Hole, Mississippi. Now, all of you are expecting, what am I going to do? Well, and all of you are also expecting there's nothing much I can do. And this is what I've done. Nothing. 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 Isn't it? So basically, that's what he did. Nothing on Friday. Whatever he said, that if he's just going to wait and see and going to postpone the decision onto next month in September, federal meeting. He increased the meeting to 2 days. So let's see whether something may happen in September. Now, for some of you may know, major things will be happening in September. You know, I've been highlighting two dates in September that you want to pay attention to. First date is September 5th, which is a Labor Day US holiday, which is on Monday, about a week from today. Second, you knew that on September 11th is the exact 10 years anniversary. Some of you may forgot there's another major date that happens in September, specifically September 15th. Pick a guess, what happened on September 15th? Now, for some of you do not know, this is what happened on September 15th. On September 15th, 2008, it will be a 3-year anniversary of Lehman Brothers collapse. Isn't it time runs really fast? 3 years already since Lehman Brothers collapse. Okay, so in other words, the month of September will be very critical because there's a lot of major anniversary happens during the month of September. Now, last week, we also had Steve Jobs, okay, the person that single-handedly built Apple from the scratch, brought Apple from almost close to bankruptcy all the way to where they are right now. Steve Jobs resigned as a CEO, and now he became a chairman of Apple. Okay, so of course the biggest news, okay, happening as of right now is Hurricane Irene. Okay, as of right now, the video is being made. It is pounding North Carolina, New York State, and Washington State. So we shall see whether does hurricane cause a major damage to the United States, the most populated area in the United States. Okay, and of course in Singapore, Dr. Tony Tan has just been elected the president of Singapore. That's the biggest news happening in the market right now. Okay? Now, okay. Of course, for us as a stock trader, as an investor, okay, the biggest news is what Ben Bernanke did not do, okay, on Friday. He didn't do anything at all. So, which means market, phew, it went up. At first, it collapsed, okay, close to 100 points lower, and then recovered all the way and closed at positive 135 points. In other words, from the low of Dow Jones on Friday, Dow Jones rallied more than 250 points, okay? 250 points rally from the low. So gone are the days when Dow Jones only up or down 40, 50, 80 points. Right now, if up or down, we're talking in terms of hundreds. Points. Okay, so let's take a look what happened to the market. Now, Apple, since Steve Jobs left, okay, Apple, if you've been following my Facebook, nicely rebounded off the resistance broken turn support. I also highlighted that Apple may be forming a descending triangle right here. Right now, Apple, it is at classical resistance. Okay, at classical resistance. Even, yes, when Steve Jobs announced, Apple gapped down. And then Apple gapped down to about, opens at about 365. In just 2 days, rally all the way up, it closed at about $383, close to $30 profit. Okay, that shows how much confidence the people have in a company called Apple. Now, some of you may felt that it may be a little bit overconfident. Well, we shall see what may happen. But as of right now, Apple is a lower high. Okay, as of right now, Apple is a lower high, same low. Potential descending triangle formation still intact. Now, on Friday, it also rallied, but the volume is not that high, not that convincing yet. So be very careful, especially if you have Apple stock. Now, S&P, Dow Jones went up 135 points. S&P also rallied tremendously. Now, the good news is S&P may be higher low, or some may say same low. Okay, so if it's the same low, we may have a potential descending triangle being formed. Okay, potential descending triangle being formed. Now, do you remember last time I said stock market always love the 20-day moving average? Will always touch the 20-day moving average. It touched. Okay, going to the upside is not that easy anymore. But since this week is the full US trading week, with next week a shortened trading week because of the Labor Day holidays. Now, if you notice, US market usually before a major holidays, market do not have major movement. But granted, all also depends on if Europe do explode. Okay, Europe do explode. If you take a look at a market watch, you notice that, where was the information? They change. Here. Europe was actually having a meeting together with Ben Bernanke in Jackson Hole, Mississippi, Wyoming, one of the states, Jackson Hole. Okay? Wyoming, Jackson Hole, Wyoming. Europe and American, they have a meeting together. So they may be planning something. Okay, they may be planning something. So we shall see what may happen. Okay? So now S&P, okay, it could be a same low, could be a higher low, but right now you need to watch is a lower high. So you need to watch to see if it can go higher than this high. That is the resistance. S&P must break. If S&P break that resistance, the next resistance will be right about here, 126, or the 50-day moving average, or notice we have a lot of resistance. These are all the potential resistance. Okay, 61.8 is going to be a very hard resistance to break. So going on upside, we are right now in bear territory. Why? Because right now, S&P is below the 200-day moving average. Anything below the 200-day moving average, bear is in control. Any rebound is an opportunity to short. If price is above the 200-day moving average, any retracement is an opportunity to buy. So right now, we are in bear territory. Okay? Now, if you take a look, why are we still in a little bit danger? It's because financial. XLF, it is actually a lower low. Okay, XLF. XLF is an ETF that tracks all the financials in US. XLF is a lower low. Okay, now US dollars. US dollars. Okay, for those of you trading Forex, you need to get excited very soon. Okay, why? Because if you notice that you've been trading US dollars over the past, since May, June, July, August, over the past 4 months, you're very frustrated because US dollars are in a ranging, trading in a range. Okay, now let me share with you something that you may miss out. If you take a look at US dollars on the weekly chart, it is right now forming a Bollinger squeeze. For those of you knowing Bollinger squeeze, you know that once a breakout, either up or down, is going to be a massive movement. So that means a trend will be developing on a weekly chart. And because this is a weekly chart, any movement will be on the weekly scale. That means any one candles are 1 week. So this will be happening. It's right now forming a Bollinger squeeze. The last time US dollars had a Bollinger squeeze was right here. And look what happened to US dollars then. Okay, so get excited. I'm not telling you it's going to go higher, but that means a trend will be developing in US dollars soon. Up or down, we'll wait for the chart to tell you. Okay, now, Hang Seng. Good news about Hang Seng. Hang Seng is a higher low. Hang Seng is a higher low. Phew. That's the good news. The bad news, upside, we still have a lot of resistance. First resistance right here. Okay, first resistance right here, which is coincide with the 20-day moving average. Second resistance right here, which also coincide with the classical support turned resistance, also with all the four moving average. Okay, so Hang Seng, wait till Hang Seng go higher. There'll be opportunity to short. That's what I've been waiting for. Okay, that's what I've been waiting for. Personally, right now, I got very, very small Hang Seng. I closed my major Hang Seng. Still got very, very small Hang Seng. Hold on just in case Ben Bernanke didn't do anything. Well, I'll be holding on. Okay, and see whether how high it can go. It is already break even. Okay, more than break even. So in other words, worst case is a break even position for me. Okay, very, very small. Okay, I'll just let it run and see what happens. It's just my itchy finger decided to enter position then. Okay, now, it's maybe first of all, first target, the 20-day moving average. Okay, so don't put yourself, put some hope, but not too much hope. Remember, we are bear territory. In bear territory, support breaks, resistance, hope. Okay, three times. I think with the elections finished, everyone in Singapore, finished. White hair, guy won. Okay, the hair that looks like this. Okay, he won. Okay, perhaps right now, market will just say, okay, one stage, one critical election, another election just passed. So we shall see what can recover. However, the bad news about straight times, it is a lower low. That's what you need to worry. Straight times is right now confirm downtrend. It's a lower high, lower low. So first resistance to be very careful. Of course, it's here. Closing of that window. Second resistance, the 20-day moving average. Third resistance, that falling window, which may coincide with the 50-day moving average. Another resistance right here, where the resistance broken turns support. Another resistance right here, which is the falling window. And of course, that falling window also coincides with the magic number 3120. Right about there. Okay. Now, on the downside, support. A very strong support will be at 2670. That's where we touched the last time. Okay. That's where we touched the last time. So the support must hold. If the support break, that's it. That's it. Why the 2670? Because if you take a look at previously, right here, supported. Right here, supported. And right here, resisted. So you notice the magic number, another magic number. Oh my goodness, another magic number, 2670. Okay, that magic number. Okay, so be very careful. Upside, a lot of resistance. So if you have long position, watch out. Okay, be very nimble. Now is not the time to buy and hold. Okay, now is not the time to buy and hold. Be very careful. All right, now, banks in Singapore are weak. DBS are weak, totally no rebound. OCBC, although good news has lower shadow, but still weak, closed black candle. UOB are also weak. Okay, which tracks like US, banks are weak. Financial are leading this turn down. Okay, which is not surprise, Europe banks also had a lot of problems. So financial are leading this point down. Okay, in terms of financial, SGX, it is, well, you can say same low, but SGX, I see this pattern. A descending triangle forming in SGX. Okay, so there are a lot of bearish signs. All right, do be very careful. Now, commodities. Commodities, I found one particular counter that has a unique chart pattern that very seldom seen. But let's go through first. Noble. Okay, Noble. What I'm worried is Noble. It went higher. The volume has not been increasing. Similar with Olam, you notice higher, but the volume is decreasing, which is very similar to what happened previously to Olam. Okay, so Olam, be very careful. Olam price went higher, volume decreasing. that means big boys are not participating. That means if the sell down come, it is going to be very fast, like what happened previously in Olam. Okay, it's going to come down fast because there's not a lot of strong support because the volume is low. All right, but Sakari, previously known as Straits Asia, it has a formation that is very seldom seen. Okay, now this guy, okay, you can see, all right, Thomas Bulowski. Okay, it's very well known. This guy is very well known for chart patterns. Okay, chart patterns. Do check it out. He wrote a lot of books on chart patterns. All right. Now, Thomas Bulowski, he mentions there is one very seldom seen, but is also very hard to trade. Okay, let's see whether it's called diamond bottoms. Can't see. Okay. Diamond bottoms. Now, diamond bottoms, according to him, he says, as an end of the day trader, I would have missed the diamond bottom by buying the situation a day after the breakout. Over in here, he also mentioned that they are high performance ranked, okay, but I discard them because of the few examples that you have seen. So, in other words, it is not easy to trade, very seldom seen. It is called diamond bottom reversal. Now, in terms of diamond bottom reversal, the target price for diamond bottom, it is right here. Okay, that means how low the price went down to the diamond bottom will be, if it does go higher, it is going to be very similar. Okay, but don't put too much hope because right now we're bear territory. All right, so don't put too much hope. Okay, now very seldom seen, but finally I've been watching for this time pattern, haven't seen it for a long time, but finally it shows up in Sakari, previously known as Straits Asia. Okay, oh, running out of time. Okay, now offshore Costco. Okay, Costco Yangtzejiang is trying to form a bottom, which is together with Keppel Corp and Sembcorp, trying to form a bottom, okay? But it is weak because the volume are not participating. If you check a look at Costco, Yangtze, Keppel Corp, Sembcorp, okay? The volume do not form a base because the volume is very decreasing. Sembmarine is trying and trying but couldn't, okay? Sembmarine is the weakest, okay? Sembmarine is the weakest. Now, if for those of you looking for Plantation, Golden Agri, Indo Agri, and Wilma, as of now, no signal. No signal. Although Wilma on Friday rallied, but as of now, there are no signal. Okay, no signal. Okay, apart from Golden Agri, which is the weakest, Indo Agri looks more convincing. But overall, to me, okay, Indo Agri right now looks like a potential bear flag. Okay, why? Because it's still within this particular candle. Inside movement of this particular candle. Okay, now properties. Okay, city development in terms of property is very erratic. So it's very hard to trade city development. Now, Capital Land, okay, and Yen Lot is also like Costco Yangtzejiang trying to form a bottom. You know, they're trying to form a bottom. But the volume is weak. Okay, so this bottom could be weak. All right, this bottom could be weak. But I want you to put your F&N into your watch list. Okay, put F&N into your watch list. Not for long, but for short. Why? First of all, because F&N right now is trying to close this particular window right here. Second, F&N, as the price goes higher, volume of F&N is decreasing. Okay, third, there's a lot of upside resistance at F&N. Okay, if you take a look at a 200-day moving average, you notice F&N somehow loves the 200-day moving average previously. This is where it touches the 200-day moving average previously. Okay, so do put F&N into your watch list for shorting position. Not now. There will be opportunity. Perhaps the month of September will let us know why. Okay, because month of September, there's a lot of major anniversaries. Everyone is very afraid. Plus, not only September, people may get out earlier because everyone is afraid of October. So you notice now the month of September, October is very, very crucial. Okay, so be very careful. If you'd like to find out more, go to my Facebook. Okay, go to my Facebook. I'll be posting my stock opinion, stock analysis right on my Facebook. Now, plus, as a homework for my internet, I also am trying to build a website for you. For you. Okay, so it's coming soon. Should be, I'm trying to add more and more features into it. You notice that now, right now, I have the YouTube right now, the channel. So now you can actually tell your friends, go to chartingacademy.com. Okay, chartingacademy.com. Tell them, go to there. It will basically link you to the Facebook and the video. Okay, one place, one stop shop for everything. Okay, once the website is up, I will also put my chart right here so that all of us can have our discussion and it's easier for you to search for charts. Because one feature about Facebook, it is very hard to search. For example, if you'd like to know what I discussed about Costco, you can't search for Costco because you have to go through back and back and back until historical wise. But with this website, all you need to do, just type Costco. Isn't it good? All right. So hopefully it should be out very soon. And I'm still putting in more features, trying to learn about how to use this template. And we shall see. So in the meantime, go to my Facebook if you can. Once in a while, take a look at my website to see if there's something new. And we shall launch a website soon. All right. So have a nice trading this week and be safe. And please remember, we are in bad territory. Long, small, run on the first sign of danger. So be safe and I'll see you next week. Thank you.